What's happening, folks, and welcome to another episode of Stars of Tomorrow, an FM20 series where we look at some of the young players on the game this year and we see how they get over the course of their careers. But players I pick from the list that I'm curious about and players that you guys give me down below in the comment section. Nice segue to which, if you've got a player you want me to have a look at, please feel free down below to leave a comment on that player. So, and don't forget, like always, to hit the subscribe button if you want to see more from the channel on FM Daily, and hit the like button and comment as well on the videos. Intro done. Let's do this. So today's player is a player that I've picked, Jonathan David. Now, I thought his name was on the way around at the start, but clearly not. And this kid looks impressive. He can play anywhere in the front four, which is very impressive for me. And I could see him as a striker very easily. But inside forward could be done, yes. I'd say these two areas are the most likely options. Looking at his development here, he's got a fairly strong left foot, so he can play him out wide. I wouldn't play him necessarily in the cam position right now because I don't think he's got the technical ability yet to play that. But then again, we'll see how he develops. Maybe we could add that into his kind of positive column in a moment. So his contract, he signed it in 2018. So you could get this guy in the first season. Again, the fee, we'll have to wait and see what the fee would be on this guy. The key attributes, obviously, are his physicality. His pace, 16. Natural fitness and 16 pace as well. Composure, 14. Finishing, 14. So, again, adds on to the idea that he could be a striker. He's Canadian, which is a nice little uniqueness there. Obviously, there's another Canadian I might do in a minute there on. If I've not already done him. So, yeah. Let's go forward, guys, and see how he gets on in the first few years. So, folks, he's still at Genk, and he's worth £13.75 million. And the only increase, really, is his finishing. But we're starting to see the technical starting to go up a little bit as well. Pace still very good. Knocks ball past opponents and runs down the right-hand side. So, indicates to me that they're playing on the right-hand side. Okay. We'll call him a striker. Let's call him a striker. I think the finishing and pace indicate he's a striker. We'll judge him as a striker. Obviously, I think you could play him anywhere, really, and you know, right training and like the right system could get something out of him. Injury records, have a look here. Okay, we've got a major hip injury in training for 3 months. Apart from that, nothing really standing out there as a worry for me personally, but you guys can make a judgment like yourself. So how has he done in the period since we started watching him? So, oh, he's at Ghent. Okay, you see what I did there, can't you? So, 9 goals, 1 assist first season. 11 goals, 0 assists, then 7-1. Went to Genk for £18 million, sorry, and got 8 goals, 2 assists, then got 8 goals, 1 assist. So, and they're playing as a striker this season. I think that's a fair place to play him. I would say you could play him inside forward on the right-hand side or left-hand side. I think I'd prefer on the right-hand side because his stronger foot is his preferred foot is right-hand side. So you could play him out there. But yeah, this is encouraging. I'm liking this. Not expensive. Looks like a really good player. Let's continue. Well, folks, he's moved to AC Milan and he's now worth £55 million. But again, solid. Nothing dropping off at all at the moment. Where they're playing this season? Mixed. Okay, he hasn't played much this season. So yeah, the pace is good. I think he's a striker. I would play him as a striker if it was me. My only worry would be the strength. But then again, I think striker or wing, definitely. I would probably go with a striker, but then again, his traits would indicate a winger, wouldn't they? So it's one of those, I think either way, you could get a lot of him. Depends who you got on the wings, I suppose, and doing your team. So history, injuries, again, since the theme of injury, again, not too bad overall. So, again, he had 8 goals and 1, then got 9 and 0. Went to AC in Milan for £22.5 million. Then got 6 and 1, 10 and 4, 9 and 4, 13 and 4. So, interesting. I think there's goals and I think he's a real bargain because the maximum paid so far is 22.5. So, he's a player that I think is definitely value for money. You've got a player who can seemingly play in all positions at this moment in time. And then, you know, pace is there, the finishing is there, it's very, very good. So, we're going to do another jump. I want to see if he continues this kind of goal return. Well, folks, not only look at that, He's got to 17 finishing. Definitely a striker. For me, anyway. Good decision making, good composure, good technique. Pace is dropped down, obviously, because he's 32. But again, the traits indicate a winger, though, don't they? So I don't know if you what you guys think. I mean, they're saying attacking midfielder, but I don't see that. I think you want him with a wide in the penalty area or in the penalty area as a striker. History of injuries, again, at a glancing view, I'm not too worried by that based on the amount of time. But again, he's getting older here, so kind of disregard that. Maybe picking more injuries now he's older. So how does an AC Milan, he's steady his whole career, got 13-4 there, then 10-3, 15-5, 13-5, 14-8, 8-10. So yeah, regularly getting 15-ish goals a season. Cheap, not expensive, can play apparently anywhere in the front four. Definitely a player to keep an eye on, guys, in your saves if you're looking for a versatile player. I like the finishing. I think it could be a simple matter of you playing wide in the early years and then sticking up front in the later years when his pace drops off, but his finishing is really high in composure. So you've got a long, I think you could argue you've got a longer term signing here, because yes, he may start as a right winger, but then again, it gets older, you might think, you know what, the pace is not there anymore. Shoot him up front if you want to do that, and I think you definitely get something out of him there as well. So guys, thank you for watching, folks. Hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button down below and leave a comment about a player you want me to review. I would say do two things. One, leave as much info on that player as possible. And second of all, check the playlist and make sure your player has not been done already. The only time I'll redo players is on the updated database, which will come out in March, I think it will be. So yeah. And also, don't forget to subscribe to see more content on the channel in your inbox on a daily basis. Or sub box, I should say, on a daily basis. So thanks for watching. See you next time. Take it away, Elton. Bye-bye.